Hey, it's Max here. So let me ask you a question. Do you know exactly why people unsubscribe from your email list? Probably not, right? Well, this is really important to figure out because then you can prevent that more people do that in the future. So that's why in this quick tip, I want to show you how you can change the unsubscribe link in ActiveCampaign so that you can link to a page on your website where you can ask people to fill out a quick survey to really learn why people unsubscribe from your list. So let's just dive right in and then I'll show you how you do this. So over here, you see just a regular email inside the email builder in ActiveCampaign. And in the bottom of your email, you need to include an unsubscribe link so that people can really easily get off your list. So this is how I'm doing that. So here I say, do you want to unsubscribe? Click here. And then the word here links to an unsubscribe page. So by default, you use the unsubscribe link personalization tag. You can also not change that because otherwise ActiveCampaign doesn't know that that person went off the list when they click that link. So we need to use this. And in a bit, I will show you how you can change that. But let me first show you what someone sees when they click this link. So when they click this link, they see this page. And I first think that their design is really not so nice, but that's maybe not the most important thing. But then also there's only just a few bullet point options that people can click why they unsubscribed. And I'm just not a huge fan of this. I much rather use like a big open user input so that people can just use their own words to explain why they unsubscribed. And the default form also has that when someone clicks other, but I think that's really a bit hidden. And I just basically only want to have this form. So what I did, I created a new page that looks like this. So I just start with, oh no, I'm sad to see you go. And I confirm that you have unsubscribed successfully. So if you want to create a custom page like this, it's really important that you confirm that people are unsubscribed because otherwise they maybe can get annoyed. Now, and then I have a little text to basically persuade people to fill out this quick survey down here. So I say, look, I get it. I've probably done something to scare you away, which is definitely not my intention. It's my mission to help you as best as I can. Everything I'm sharing, I try to make valuable and relevant, but it looks like I screwed up big time. And for that, I'm sorry. As a fellow entrepreneur, I'm sure you know exactly how important feedback is. You would help me a lot if you could take 15 seconds to describe in one sentence why you decided to leave. Thanks. And then you see here that I have just a really simple form. I created this form with Contact Form 7. That's a plugin for WordPress, but it really doesn't matter how you enter this form in here. Just have like one field. What is the main reason you unsubscribed and have people click send? So of course, this survey doesn't get filled out so often. These are people that unsubscribed, they're not so engaged anymore, but sometimes you get really, really good feedback. So let me show you an entry that I got yesterday. So here we have someone who says, good morning, Max, nice videos about ActiveCampaign. I found you on YouTube. I like the way to perfect this AC stuff, but for me, it's too many emails. I'd love to receive only the most necessary emails and not be overwhelmed with small little teaser-like stuff. Well, I think this is really good feedback. And if we read a bit more, then you'll see what this person is doing. And also gives feedback on my videos. For example, it says, also for newbies, it's not self-explanatory what lead magnets, funnels, and stuff are. Would be great to describe those with different words in your videos. And I was like, hey, this is actually really good feedback, right? Like I could do something with that. Maybe I can use different terms, or I could create some videos about what lead magnets are, what funnels are, etc., etc. And then here you see another entry, very short. Someone says, no automations, please check your links. And then when I got this email, I was like, okay, let me check. So then I just quickly looked which person unsubscribed at this time. And then I noticed that my links were broken inside the email that he got. So then I was able to fix it. Well, if I only had this bullet point list, I would probably never have figured that out. So I think this is really great. So let me show you how you can change that custom unsubscribe link. So from this, we want to change it to this. So just create like a super simple page. You really don't have to make it super pretty or overcomplicated. Just have like a super simple form in it. So I want to use this page, maxvankollenburg.com/buy. Then we go over to ActiveCampaign. Then you have to go over to your lists. And then we have to go over here. So for example, I have a customer list and a main list. I'll go to my main list And then we go to advanced settings. Then you go to public pages. And then here you see unsubscribe confirmation. And then we click here, edit. And then here, what we can do, we can say redirect to a URL instead. So we can just change this thing, redirect, and then we click here, save. And then we have to do the same thing for the customer list. We click here, redirect to a URL instead, and we click save. And then it's very important that we click here, save again, because otherwise it doesn't work. And that's basically already it. So you only have to create a really simple page on your website with a one question survey that people can fill out. And then you can start learning why people unsubscribe from your list. So I already got some great feedback from it. So I hope you will learn from it as well. If you like this video, give it a little thumbs up. That really helps me a lot. And be sure to subscribe if you want to see more tutorials like this.